What's going on, guys? Today we got some fun stuff, we got some boring stuff, and we got shit to do. Follow me. Alright, so the first thing on my list today is I need to get this exhaust onto the LS2 E36. And I was going to put it up, and I realized that we didn't have the gaskets for the actual exhaust. We only need to make two because the rest are V-bands. So I went ahead and I went, because I don't know where I'm going to find this. I don't know what exhaust this is, whatever. I don't know where I can actually find the right exhaust gasket. So I went to Advanced Auto, and I got this make it your own gasket stuff. So I just finished scraping this side off. I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to lay a strip, I'm going to cut it, and then I'm going to try to make my own gasket. See if it works. Guys, so I'm just about to finish my first gasket, and honestly, came out a lot better than I was anticipating. I've only been working on it for about 3 minutes, and this is what I got so far. I did mess up a little over here, but as long as it has like a full like seal along here, that's not gonna be too much of a big deal. And just to do the hole, what I did, I'm gonna show you guys, I'm gonna time lapse this one, but I poked it, I went all the way over here, and then I kind of just like curved along like that, and then I just electrical taped it down so it didn't move. And now I just gotta drill the holes, so I'm gonna find the right drill bit size for these holes right here, and then this one will be done, and then we can time lapse that one. All right, first gasket is done. Looks pretty good for my first time ever. Now I'm just gonna flip this around. I'm gonna start scraping this, and this is kind of an, oh, that's actually not that bad. This one, it took me like 10 minutes to do because this stuff's like cement, but I have to scrape all of this off, and then we can start making a new gasket. Okay, so now all the gaskets off except a little bit right there actually. It's hard to get this right here because whatever car this was on before, it was low, so it created like a kind of like a bevel, and like I can't put the razor straight like that, so I kind of have to get it at like an angle. Should be good. Feels smooth. So now I'm gonna set up my tripod. We're gonna get the new gasket made. All that work for nothing. This one came out so good too, fuck! Fucking drill bit, I'm so pissed. All right guys, so I'm about to put the exhaust on right now. Made this little contraction, whatever the fuck, however you say it. They're bleeding brakes, so I figured I didn't want to wait. So I'm here trying this. It's working pretty well, so I just gotta like tighten these zip ties and bring this thing up, push it forward a little. It's not bad, not bad at all. Not bad, my little jig worked. Took me about 7 minutes to get this up. Now I just gotta tighten these bolts right here. I need to find some bolts because the exhaust mounts to that little threaded stud right up here. So I need to find some bolts for that. And then a V-band hooks up to this, to the end. And then, what do you think it's gonna sound like, good?
It's gonna sound like a V8 through a, actually, I've heard it, because this was on Tony's car.
Does it sound good?
Sounded sick. You can look at my videos in the past from like a year and a half ago.
Is that right?
It's pretty right.
$20, you're not bad, right?
Where'd you get that?
Macro guy, ooh, God.
You looked right into it. What are you gonna do, mount this up here?
Yeah.
I have a nut for that.
Do you have two nuts?
Yeah. I have the
correct.
Don't
mess with it too much, because those aren't in.
Or they're in, but
what
they're not
the
tight.
Fuck is
dude,
all
it
that?
Worked. It only took me 7 minutes to get that up. It's not bad.
What'd you look at your video?
Yeah. All right, guys, so the exhaust is fully on. I started to attempt to put the front end on. Realized I have no bolts. Kind of forgot how it went on because like I said, I have no bolts or anything to do this, so it's kind of difficult. So I kind of just have like the lights placed here. And then I tried setting up this thing, and it's just not working out too well without any bolts. But I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna start it, and then I'm gonna quickly lift it up, and then check for leaks and then shut it off because we don't have a belt yet. I just ordered an LS1 pump because the LS2 pump's not gonna work. And I also ordered the bracket kit for the LS1 to mount the LS1 pump. So we should be good there. And I guess I need to order hardware, which is very fucking annoying because like it like takes like a bunch of these and like these go behind the light right here. And then I don't even know how it fucking works, honestly, I don't. I think it goes like this. And then you put the bowl. I really don't fucking know. It's kind of irritating, but I'm gonna go ahead and start it right now. All right, let's make this snappy, Chris. Honestly, we're pretty fucking good. Sick. I wish I could rev it, but my sensor's broken. So if I even hit the gas pedal, nothing happens. I wish I could rev it for you guys and like set up the tripod and everything, but the fly-by-wire sensor doesn't work. So like when I push the gas pedal, it doesn't open the throttle body or anything. It literally does nothing. So I need to order another one of those. I actually already ordered it. It should be at AutoZone right now. I actually might just go pick that up right now. I have nothing to do. This front end's stressing me the fuck out. All right, hopefully my SD card's working. I keep saying it's corrupted, which doesn't make any sense. But anyways, I called Advance Auto. They don't have my sensor. They said they were gonna have it in. Then I called them and then they said it got lost or like Middletown or whatever, thought they had it in their inventory and they really didn't. So they're ordering that. The LS1 pump is on the way. Also, once we get both of those, we can actually start driving this around. I was gonna put the shifter in tonight, but I don't have the hardware for that. I was gonna put the front end on tonight, but I don't have the hardware for that. Honestly, I'm motivated right now. If I had all the shit to do this, if I had it all right here, right in front of me, I would literally finish this car right now. Like, I wanna get this car done. I wanna start driving it around, but it sucks waiting on parts and it sucks doing all that stuff, so. In the meantime, what I'm gonna do is I've been kind of neglecting my RC cars and they've both been broken and I've been too lazy to fix them, but now is the perfect time because the hobby shop's open for another half an hour. I need to go get a new wheel because this is all mangled in there. This is what happens when you run a 3-cell and a brushless motor at the same time, just kind of breaks everything. But I'm slowly getting it all aftermarket shit. I need to go get some new suspension because this shit's junk, it keeps blowing out. Hopefully they have sick wheels because I kind of want to get rid of all of them. And that's it for this. And I just needed a new A-arm. This thing right here, it snapped hitting a huge jump. So I need to go get one of those. So I'm going to go to the hobby shop right now. I'm going to get all this stuff. I'm going to maybe get a new body too because I would like to get a new body, just like a clear one. Maybe I can spray paint and put some of my own stickers on it. Put that Rudnick face on. If you guys haven't checked it out, go down in the bio below. Check it out. Buy one. Support a cause, and so meet you at the hobby shop. All right, just got all the stuff I needed. This is the track. I don't really have a good lens for this, but we have like a drift track right here and a sick track here. Been here twice, but every time I come, I kind of spend like $100. Like I just spent $130 because every time I drive these things, man, I break them. They're so delicate, but they just came out with the new E-Revo. It goes like 70 out of the box, and I really want to buy it, but it's $550, so I don't know. I'll look at it one day, not right now. All right, so I just got back to the shop, got some new wheels, got battery holder for the Stampede, battery holder for the Rustler, new suspension for the Rustler, a new set of these for the Stampede, front and rear, got a new clutch just in case, got some hardware, and I'm gonna throw all this stuff in and then I'll have two running RC cars again. All right, so this little fucker's fixed. We've got the new suspension on it. Check this out. I've only owned this thing for a couple months. I've replaced all the arms on it. I got metal knuckles in there. They're blue. In the rear, we got metal axles, more metal, fucking everything. Brushless, the whole nine yards. That thing's ready to go. This thing, I just changed out one arm. I got all four, but I'm kind of cheap and I like to make sure the plastic ones break first and then I'll change it to metal, but I want to run the plastic as long as I can because I'm cheap, I know, but we're just gonna test these bad boys real quick, see if they work. All right, Rustler test, here we go. Oh, all right, so Rustler works. Hey. I don't want to go too crazy because I don't have the bodies on, but see if we can burn some rubber here. Oh, I'm going to explode that tire if I keep going. Maybe we can do some donuts. Let's see if I can hold the camera and do donuts. I don't know if you can see, but... Oh, it's in the bush. Here we go. Oh. Ow, I got pelted.
Well, that was cool.
Well, guys, I'll tell you right now, this is my least favorite RC car that I ever owned. Just because, one, it's so tall that it always flips. I drove it for about 2 minutes now, and it already sounds like the clutch is slipping, which is super annoying. Three, I was driving, and I tried turning, and it flipped right into my tripod and totally just knocked my camera and fell on the ground, so I don't know if my camera's okay, but... Yeah, fuck this thing. Like, you can't even do donuts. It doesn't even want to, like, steer. This thing's ignorant as fuck. I guess we'll just do a launch.
3, 2, 1.
And it's the fucking tripod again, dude. Fuck this thing. I'm done with it. I hate this thing. All right, so they're both fixed. Fuck you. I love you. You're staying right there. You're not getting touched. But anyways, I guess this is the end of the video. I said in the beginning we had a lot of stuff to do, and that's because I wanted to do the shifter, I wanted to do the front end, and I actually wanted to drive it today, just around the block real quick. Not even around the block, just around the shop, because we don't have the belt on yet because we're waiting on the power steering pump. But I couldn't do that anyways because the accelerator is all messed up, and we're also waiting for that part. But this car, I want it to get done very, very soon. Like I said, I have the motivation to finish it and everything. It's just waiting on parts. I'm just like so stressed out. I just want to rip my fucking hair out right now, but it'll be done soon. It's such a bummer, man. I'm sick of looking at this thing on the lift. I just want to get it done and like be able to see it and drive it whenever I want to, and it's fucking stressful. But that's gonna be it for this video, guys. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. Want to subscribe for more, subscribe for more. Tomorrow I think I'm gonna go to a pick and pull junkyard to get all the hardware for that, because I don't feel like waiting on new hardware. I just want to get this thing done. So I'm gonna go to a pick and pull junkyard. I'm gonna get like the headlight hardware, I'm gonna get like the bumper hardware and all that stuff, so I can actually make it into a complete car. Stay tuned for that. And also, you guys ordered a Rudnick face sticker and it was on a pre-order. Zip Ties got them in 2 days ago, and literally right when they got it, they shipped them all out. So if you haven't already gotten it yet, you should be getting it very, very shortly. And if you want to buy a Rudnick sticker, all you got to do is go down to the link below. We have them back in stock, so it's no longer a pre-order. So if you want one and you don't want to wait, then pick it up and it can be yours tomorrow. See you tomorrow.